All right, guys, so I'm going to share a video with you guys because I just want us to draw a perspective. And this is for the civil societies, and this is for former government officials, because when our people are being ostracized, it is your responsibility, especially civil society. And Thomas More knows about this. I saw the video they released the last time, which you talked about this, the roles of civil society in the current democratic dispensation. And so the problem that we have today is because civil societies are not actually standing up for the people. And what is happening across the country, and you take the situation of what's happened in Belgium, for example, where you have a sector of our society is so informal, the way that our economy is. And these are people that are going there, you know, to do business, you know, legitimate business to get away, you know, to survive and take care of their families and all that stuff. But take a listen to these Senegalese activists, the roles that they're playing. And this is why, like I said, would hold the civil societies accountable if anything happens to our people, because people in their countries have a right to express themselves through free speech, through protest, whatever way they can talk to the government. And the way to prevent this from happening is when civil societies actually do their jobs. So the question is, what is the civil society doing in protecting the citizens of Sierra Leone today when this government is using the long arm of the law, you know, to ostracize its people? We saw what happened at King Jimmy and Belgium there. And we want to prevent that. And that is where the civil society is coming. Take a look at this video.
Okay, let's get going. Let's bring in our guests today. Joining us all from the Senegalese capital, Dakar, we have Aminata Touré, formerly a prime minister of Senegal. Yacine Fall, an economist and founding member of the Movement for the Defense of Democracy. And Ousmane Diallo, Francophone West Africa researcher at Amnesty International. A warm welcome to you all. Yacine Fall, from the opposition's stance, this country, Senegal, used to be the high watermark of stable democracy in West Africa. What changed and why?
What changed is the fact that we are really at a crossroads. We are at a crossroads because we have right now a president, but the president has repeatedly said that he will reduce opposition to its minimum level of existence. The president has had also a practice of regularly, and this is the third time, undermining its major opponent, using the courts to the point where that opponent is not able to run for elections. The third thing is we have seen a situation of really, you know, political harassment of civil society, of activists and of political leaders. We have also seen a high reduction of liberties, because before, you know, we were allowed to, you know, demonstrate peacefully in the streets. This president was able to be elected because there was a big social movement against Ablaye Wade, and that social movement was given the enabling conditions to demonstrate, almost invade the parliament when Ablaye Wade was trying to vote himself into a third term.
Okay, Aminata Touré, yes, Ms. Fall, just let me put those points to Aminata Touré, the former prime minister. Ms. Touré, as a journal of record, what Yacine Fall is saying there is factually correct. The three significant opposition leaders who have stood against the incumbent recently have all been in effect airbrushed out of the process by a use by somebody or some people of the legal system.
In the fourth quarter of this year, we plan to go public at the New York Stock Exchange. Today, you may...
Well, let me just maybe speak to the situation right now, and my greeting also to Yacine, who's an activist and a great woman rights defender and rights defender. I do think that the situation as we speak, is concerning, that for sure. If we see what happened, Senegal, as you said, is known as, you know, a good, great example in Africa of stable democracy. So how did we get here? So I think it's a very important question. Obviously, and I've said that when I was in position, in governmental position, the issue of third term is way behind us. I mean, this is something that we don't expect anybody to discuss about. For me, it is very, very clear. I said it several times, and the president himself said it in the past. So I expect that in 2024, you know, we will have an election without the current president. That's my hope. But what happened is that for a year, a COVID impacted year, you know, the economy of the country, you know, took a terrible hit. And as you know, we do have an economy that is 80% informal. And that's where usually young people, you know, get some earnings, being in shops, in small tradings. And for a year of curfew, of course, they got terribly impacted. Okay. Some of them tried to join Europe. You know, 500 people died. So this added to the frustration of not being sure about the democratic future, that for sure.
Okay, we will return to COVID, I'm sure.
So guys, so this is why I'm sharing this video with you all, because I want other former politicians, when you're serious, if you're opposition that is very serious for all the opposition parties in Sierra Leone, mostly, of course, we know APC is the biggest opposition, because, but if you are serious opposition, this is the stance that you take, because you want to defend the people against these kinds of acts so that when you come to power, that is not the same thing that you're going to be doing. What is different with everything that these people are saying? Guys, these videos should be a learning point for the civil societies in our country. It should be a learning point for the opposition leaders. It doesn't matter if you've been a former president, former prime minister. When things that are going on in a country that is eroding our democracy, the very fabric of our democracy is being eroded, I think it's your place to stand up and defend your people. There's nothing wrong with that, but it's this silence. Just the way now President Bio is even treating us, does not talk to the people, regardless of everything that is happening, all the killings that are going on in the country. He's not talking about it. He's not speaking up about it. And nobody's holding him accountable. The civil society, the journalists, nothing is happening. The opposition, nobody's calling this man out for what he's doing. But these videos shows that civil societies have a moral obligation and former government officials have a moral obligation to defend and protect its people and protect our democracy above all. Sierra Leone is the only country we have. Thank you.